Italia 1990, when Stuart Pearce missed the penalty. Gazza broke down in tears, and Gary Lineker, it was that look over when he said, "Have you got a minute?"
Ray Howden scored for the Republic of Ireland in the 1994 World Cup. The quarterfinals, it was against Italy. The whole of Ireland had turned out in the pubs as usual. There was a lot of Guinness flowing, a lot of fun, a lot of laughter, and the last thing we expected was to score a goal against Italy, who were the favourites for the World Cup.
Hand of God, my eye. It was an absolute disgrace, and how you could get away with that and claim it, I'll never know.
I was a professional footballer in the 1960s, and after the World Cup in 66, when England won it, of course, we found our record sales of our season tickets went up alarmingly. Teams I played for were Luton and Gillingham, and Gillingham in particular had a world record when it came to sales, 125% in one day. So therefore it was a very, very good impetus for England to win the World Cup and for other footballers and football teams in that area to actually enjoy the benefits of it all.
Italia 90, and it was because Steve Ball was selected for the England squad. Steve Ball played for Wolverhampton Wanderers, who were then in the third division, which was the third tier of English football. He was such a local lad and such a legend for everybody on the terraces. It was like seeing your mate at the World Cup in the England squad, and the whole of Wolverhampton just ground to a halt. It would have done anyway, but it was just like a ghost town, and everybody remembers it. Not for the fact we got the semi-final, which was great, but Steve Ball, our mate, was there.
David Beckham, 1998. A great young player, did very well for England, went from hero to villain in one foul second, and regretted it for the next 4 years.
Following England through Germany in 2006, watching it on a big screen that was placed on the river that runs through Frankfurt, on an absolutely roasting day with a fire brigade behind us, hosing us down to keep us cool. I don't know if they were worried about our tempers or not, but we won the game.
When England were winning the World Cup against Germany, I was in fact watching it from our supporters' room. They invited all the players in for a drink, and we were there celebrating. And I still reckon that Jeff Hurst was not over the line anymore.
1966, probably the first one that I remember, when I had a boyfriend and just met, and they constantly football every night. And then it's been the same ever since, really.
Well, 1966, England won. And that night I had a date with a woman, ended up marrying her. And that was the biggest and worst day of my bloody life, so.
And here comes Hurst, he's got some dinner on the pitch, they think it's all over. It is done.